Heartbreakers. If you ask me, a very entertaining comedy, especially given that Gene Hackman, a legend, an icon, a god, a glorious actor, one of the best. He projects so much power, strength, villainy in Unforgiven, for which he had one of the two Oscars. Is it two? I think it's two. I hope it's so. This Chris Cuomo in the background, you know, talking with the elections and the very stable genius. So he is fantastic. And here he has a comic role. And so just those scenes, watching him, for me, give enough pleasure to make the film enjoyable, more than watchable. I was tempted to say memorable, but that would be subjective. That would be going a bit far, because it's not so overwhelming overall. And if you ask other critics, the important, the ones you should, in fact, look for, they have an average score, a meta score, which you can find on the IMDb site for every movie. Almost every movie, it only has to have enough coverage, enough criticism, so that you have an average score. If it's just two, three critics that have written about it, that's not possible. They don't give you a meta score. So, to mention though, well, some of what happens in those scenes, and Gene Hackman in the movie is an old, decaying, wealthy man. And the character played by Sigourney Weaver, the mother, is out there to get his wealth. She pretends to be Olga. I remember her name somehow. Russian, that speaks of that strange accented English, foreigner from Russia or one of the former Soviet republics. Or the East in general, maybe it's, I have the same accent, I don't know. Coming from behind the Iron Curtain of the old days. So in one, I thought funny, morbid, but funny. He keeps smoking, that's for sure. But he says, in front of a cage with a parrot. That's not a macaw, but a medium-sized one, I think I've seen. So he keeps smoking, and he says, "I don't know what they keep." They keep saying with the tobacco companies they made them pay, but there's no evidence for that. And in this cloud of smoke, he turns around to watch Olga to see what she's gone on, and behind him, on his side, the poor bird drops dead in that small cloud of smoke coming from his cigar or cigarettes, whatever he's smoking. I think it's cigarettes. So there you have it. Not that I wouldn't be tempted to try a cigar and see what the effect is upon the blue and gold one. Crazy one. The other one is a nice, gentle fellow, friend. Puccini, red and green. So there are machinations. They have schemes. Mother and daughter. Daughter is Jennifer Love Hewitt. To try and get those people, until the daughter falls in love. And there you have a game of cat and mouse in some ways. She's at some stages thinking of getting him because they have to get some money back to the character played by Ray Liotta. He's also in this amusing comedy. And the humor is accidental, evolving around getting rid of the body of the now dead Gene Hackman, old wealthy man. The cadaver falls from some upper floor. Then they have to put him in the car. They have to get him back. There's a statue with a rigid penis. They want to use it as a reason for why he died. He just stumbled upon the penis of the statue. So you get what I'm going. It's helped by some very solid performances. As I said, towering Gene Hackman, that's as good as it gets. Sigourney Weaver and Love Hewitt and Ray Liotta, of course. So, not there in the top 100 best comedies, but good.